Good night, everyone. It's December 1st, 2020. With this, we start the show Confirmado la Moncloa, a review of the Spanish political situation. It will be around 30 minutes long to focus on a few ideas. As always, we will start with the comment of the day. We will start with today's comment. A few days ago, I was asked, how was I able to keep so calm with the extreme situation we're living? And one thinks about this and asks, are we really living a strange situation, an extreme one, something different than the normal? Or maybe just people that weren't used to these extreme situations are just finding themselves in a situation they were not used to? Because the truth is, we're in a really, really complicated situation, and we're not gonna lie about that. Some of us, maybe more, maybe less, have already lived really complicated and extreme situations in last years on our own. But now the thing is, it is affecting a lot of people, and they're able to talk with others. And whomever had a more like normal life is finding themselves in a really complicated situation because it doesn't have a solution. It is a complicated moment. One has to decide by its own, listen, ponder and think about it. The difference with those that we think we've lived complicated situations that those living them now are not alone. And between all of, we can just talk about it and see others' opinions and also help each other. And today, we could call the day of the insolence. We will talk about things that are just surprising for many of us, and we will also start with a headlines of the day. The first one is about the Transparency Council that has asked the government for the documents publishing who is part of the committee that has been advising the government about the healthcare and how to manage the virus. It seems like Sánchez's government is hiding and lying about many things, and one of them is the committee of who is advising them in the healthcare issues. The second headline is the renovation of the Council of the Judicial Power, that the government is saying that, or it is renovated now, or it will make changes in the law that regulates how it is chosen. Third headline is Europe denies asking for changes in the secession crime. Pedro Sánchez said it was a European petition, and Europe is very vigilant of this government. Europe isn't too happy with many decisions this government is making. The fourth headline of the day is Moderna wants to approve its vaccine. We will see which government approves it and with what conditions. So now we will enter into today's comment of the day. The news that keep coming up is just total chaos. Not only because Pablo Iglesias is trying to assault the government, but also because their companions, the ones that are supporting them, ERC, ERC, Esquerra Republicana de Catalunya, the pro-independence political party, and Bildu, are asking of Pedro Sánchez's government a historical solution. And since Sánchez's unique goal is to stay on office and power, it seems that these both political parties have chosen the right moment to demand this from the government. Part of Iglesias's assault to the government is this coalition with Bildu and ERC political parties. And we will see with the old school of the PSOE, the Social Democrats here in Spain, what they do, if they do something or not. And other sections of the political party of the Social Democrats that are starting to get organized between themselves to try and stop this fall. Because the truth is that most of the people that are living a good life, thanks to having the government of the Social Democrats, they know that when this government finishes, they have a very little chance to continue in their positions and salaries. Because their continuity is only guaranteed if they have total loyalty to Sánchez, to their leader, their extreme leader. And they know that Sánchez right now is in the worst situation possible in the last few months. The polls start to show results against them, And there are voices in the Social Democrats that start to show their disagreement with the political party. And there is a key point, the insolence. When a government works like that, when they work with impunity, it means that that government is just adrift. For example, today in a newspaper, it said that healthcare minister Iya chose for a big contract the business spoiled by Minister Ábalos, a business that not much ago had a turnover of 100,000 euros, and now this business is being awarded contracts for thousands of euros. And it's really sad that contracts are being awarded this way. And it's really sad that the government just really doesn't care what they say about them because they just have the media eating from their hand. That the government knows that whatever they do, it doesn't matter, that no one will say nothing at all. We'll be honest, this government just seems like allegedly composed by criminals. And also the media. The media can't just be so bought that with a call of Ivan Redondo or other members of the government tell them what to say, and they do. Where's the media's decency? Because we really know that politics here in Spain has no decency. But it seemed like the media had a little bit of decency, but where's that decency now? For example, Cadena Ser, El País, and the rest of the media. Totally bought by the government. They're capable of just saying anything just to obtain their subsidies and to just keep on living in this world of insolence. Because in the end, the democracy is something we build. It is built by every person. But some think that democracy is only them. And we not only think that they're wrong, but we also think they're not doing any favor to this country. And we must say it and show and pinpoint who they are. It doesn't seem democratic that the big contract of health by Minister Illa is to a business that's friends with Minister Ábalos, and that the media is not saying a single thing, not at all. And another scandal is that the government is saying and entering into the first headline that if the renovation of the Council of the Judicial Power isn't approved, that they will make the changes by decree. Is that democratic? Is that just following the rules and the laws? Will we have to tell Europe again so they can say something to the government? Will we have to wait and see what the Council of Transparency says again? Maybe also about the Judicial Power Council? Like with the list of experts that is giving advice to the government about the health and that they're not giving the names? And once the Transparency Council has asked for the names, the government just said that they're thinking about it. This is just a big shame. There are no words left to explain this situation. Also, Europe Today made clear that Europe isn't asking changes in the secession crime, like what happened with the VAT for the face masks, that the government lied and Europe had to say it wasn't true that Europe was imposing the VAT on the face masks. Europe said it was okay to lower it. But Pedro Sánchez's government lied and keeps lying about the VAT of the face masks. The shame is all the voters that would still be voting this government that we have, even when they've just lied, gone against the law, the constitution, and everything. And those that just keep voting this kind of government, the government we have, the Social Democrats with Unidas Podemos, Pedro Sánchez's government, is just not thinking. It's just being incompetent, tolerating a government that just abuses its power, that just humiliates the country and the people, and that just keeps on lying and doing things against the law. And the government of Pedro Sánchez is just being so insolent that sometimes it's just embarrassing having to explain some things. Entering into the fourth headline, for example, Moderna that wants to approve its vaccine with only some weeks testing when it's normally 2 years. It just seems like in Spain everyone is just turning crazy. When the incompetents get to the power, to the government, and there's a problem, they just act like the total incompetents they are. We have a total incompetent government voted by total incompetents and just followed by just fans. instead of people that think the political party they're voting, and see if after voting them they have the luck to obtain a salary. They don't even think how the public money is managed. They don't think that the money is from every one of us, like from the freelancers that today they've just increased our fees to pay without it telling us, without saying anything, just making us pay more. And some may think, oh no, as long as I have a salary, a payment done by the government, or a subsidized, that's fine. Well, where do you think the money comes from? Think about it, please. Do you think the money is just under a stone? Or that it's just created out of magic? Well, please, just read the news, talk with people, see the reality. And if we have 8 or 10 million incompetent people when voting and deciding and judging what political party and what government is good or bad, please, maybe we should just change the system. And truth be told, it's true that the opposition, when they could, they're also at fault, since they could have changed it and they didn't. Because whoever believes in democracy nowadays should be thinking about education, training, and for having people that are able to think by themselves. And if after all of that they still don't vote you, you should be happy. But because you should think that they have decided something with intelligence. But we're so used to the parties to just simply indoctrinate, so they vote their political party, that they don't care if they have culture, if they know how to think, or if they're simply totally incompetent people. They simply want voters. We would like to remember that in the end, life is just a competition between different countries, and the one with the most inferior level may be able to keep in power Sánchez or the governor they have, or even Iglesias or whoever is president, a total incompetent person with a terrible curriculum. We could call Sánchez and Iglesias the one from the halls and the liar. Because if that allows them to just keep having a salary paid at everybody's expense, well, it's their problem. And we have to keep calm, but we have to say the truth and to be really clear with what we say and what's happening. And today is the day of the insolence. Iglesias has chosen the worst companions of the class. ERC, the pro-independence of Catalonia, and the Bildu, the friends of ETA. And Sánchez, with his incompetence, hand by hand of Iván Redondo, that doesn't even know how to play chess. They probably are just trying to add up numbers. That's the only thing that they know how to do. The big problem is that a country isn't just the sum of representatives in the Congress. Well, no. It comes from having ideas, people voting or not voting you, having the ability to decide and think by themselves. And that doesn't seem to happen in this country. And a last consideration. A lot of the media are at fault of the current situation. Going to put an easy example. Today at 10 p.m. I wanted to watch something on TV, and I think they were just doing like Sálvame. In another channel, something about lovers, and so on with the other channels. And that this is what most people watch just says a lot of the country in itself. And as we have said in other occasions, with pity we say, this country has what it deserves. A president like Sánchez. In a country with stupid people, the country deserves a stupid president. Because a president, after all, is just a representation, a reflection of the society. And no matter what we do, if we don't move those 8 million that are voting him, the path will be really difficult. Even with Iglesias assaulting the government and being today the day of the insolence, the solution isn't near enough here for Spain. Remember to stick around, or as we would say in Spain, seguimos.